Students, let us learn what is linear inequation. Suppose 2x plus 5 less equal to x plus 9. Here you see only one variable is related. So it is simple inequation, and the power of x, the highest power of x is 1. That's why it is called linear inequation. Let us learn what is solution. Solution of the inequation. Suppose x less equal to 10 whenever x belongs to w, that is whole number. So what is the solution? Here you see 0 is a member of this. So in an inequation, a set of values, a set of solutions are there. This set of solutions is called solution set. So here is solution set is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Because x belongs to w, that is the whole number, so 0 is included, and all these values satisfies the condition. Hence, this is the solution set. Whether a number is a solution of the inequation or not, simply just put the value whether the given condition satisfies or not. Suppose you are taking the value x equal to 11. You see x not less than or equal to 10. So it never be the solution of this inequation. That is, for this value, it is not true. So only these values satisfies the inequation. Hence, it is called solution set. Students, let us learn how we represent the solution set in graphs. That is, graphical representation of the solution set. Suppose 3x plus 5 less equal to 2x plus 10, where x belongs to n. That is, x is a natural number. This implies that 3x plus 5 minus 5 less equal to 2x plus 10 minus 5. Subtracting 5 from both the sides. Students, you know, if a less than b, this implies that a minus c less than b minus c. This implies that 3x less equal to 2x plus 5. Again, we subtract 3x minus 2x less equal to 2x plus 5 minus 2x. Subtracting 2x. This implies that x less equal to, here 2x to x cancelled, 5. So the solution set is, what is the solution set? Since x is the natural number, so the solution set is, suppose this is number line and this is 0. So the solution set on the number line can be represented by the dots. here 1, it is 2, it is 3, it is 4 and it is 5. Here is the solution set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So all the dotted points are the solution set. Let us solve the inequation where x belongs to I. Here given 3 less equal to 5x minus 7 less equal to 28. Here 5x minus 7 less equal to 28 greater equal to 3. This implies that 3 plus 7 less equal to 5x minus 7 plus 7 less equal to 28 plus 7. This implies that 10 less equal to 5x less equal to 35. This implies that if we divide all the terms of the inequation by 5, that is the positive number 5, so the relation will remain same. So it will be 2 less equal to x less equal to 7. Here dividing by 5, so the solution set is, since x belongs to I, hence the solution set equal to 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Students, let us represent the solution set graphically. If we put the solution set on the number line, we will get the points these dotted points 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. These points are the solution set of the inequation. Students, here is the given inequation. We have to find out the maximum and minimum value of x. So we can write minus 1 less equal to 1 by 7 into 3x minus 4 less equal to 5. If we multiply all the terms by 7, the relation will remain same. So minus 7 less equal to 3x minus 4 less equal to 35. Now let us add 4 in all the terms. Minus 7 plus 4 less equal to 3x minus 4 plus 4 less equal to 35 plus 4. This implies that minus 3 less equal to 3x, here 4 minus 4 cancelled, less equal to 39. This implies that, students, we know if A less equal to B, this implies that A by C less equal to B by C, where C is greater than 0. That is, the relation will remain same if we divide both the numbers by a positive number. So let us divide the inequation by 3. So it will be minus 1, here x, and here it will be 13. In my earlier video, we have learned if x be a variable and k and m be two constants such that x less equal to k and greater equal to m, then we can write k is the maximum value of x and m is the minimum value of x. Suppose x greater equal to 2, less equal to 5. So every value of x must be less equal to 5. So 5 is the highest value of x. Again, every value of x must be greater equal to 2. So 2 is the minimum value of x. Hence, here is m is the minimum value of x and k is the maximum value of x. Similarly, here c, x less equal to 13 and greater equal to minus 1. So from this relation we can write maximum value of x equal to 13 and minimum value of x equals to minus 1. Students, in physics or higher mathematics, these sorts of relations are usually used. Let us solve a problem. Formula for calculating IQ is given by IQ equal to m by a into 100, where m equal to mental age and a equal to physical age. If a boy of 15 years with IQ greater than 80 and less than 140, find the mental age of the boy. Here given IQ equal to m by a into 100. Age of the boy is given 15 years. Here a equal to 15. Therefore, IQ equal to m by 15 into 100. Suppose m is the mental age of the boy. Now, from this relation, we can write m by 15 into 100 less than 140 greater than 80. This implies that 80 into 15 less than m into 100 less than 140 into 15. Once again, we divide all the terms by 100. So we get 80 into 15 by 100 less than m less than 140 into 15 by 100. Let us cancel 0 here, it is 3, and it is 2, and again it is 7. And here we cancel 0, 0, it is 3, it is 2, and it is 4. This implies that 12 less than m less than 21. So the mental age of the student is less than 21 and greater than 12. So we can conclude that the range of mental age of the student is in between 12 to 21. Students, in this chapter we have learned what is inequation, what is the solution, and what is the solution set, why so many values satisfies the in equation and graphical representation of the solution set. Knowledge of this chapter is very much important for higher studies students. If you like my video, please share the video to your friends and simply put like to my video. Thank you for watching my video.
Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to get all the notifications. You can also like the video and share the video in your groups.